So guys, first of all, I would like to thank you all for 200 subscribers. I did not know that we have reached 200 subscribers, more than 200 subscribers, and I'm really happy about it. So, and it's because of you, all of my friends, all of my family members, and everyone who supported me for my YouTube channel and is supporting me till now with a very positive vibe. We say what we say. Thank you so much, guys, from bottom of my heart. And I think we're gonna grow more, and Life Multiway family will grow more. I hope you enjoy the video. I'm really, really grateful of you all. Hey guys, welcome back to another video. So today, in this video, we are in Delhi Heart, and I wanted to come here for the longest time, and finally I'm here. So I'm really excited. So I'm gonna show you different things what are here. So, and then please subscribe the channel and also like my videos. So finally I have entered Delhi Heart, and there are ticket charges, and the ticket charges are 30 rupees, and for children I guess it's 20. So yes, they have ticket charges also. And so basically, Delhi Heart has people, vendors from different corner of this country, which shows their basic things, like the regional things, and that is why this place is famous. It's quite expensive, but of course, if you are in Delhi, that means you can bargain. So bargain a lot here also. So as you can see, there are a lot of paintings, and they are really beautiful, and I think they are really expensive also. You can see Assam tea if you want. So there are regional shawls. These are pure shawls. These are from some northeast country, state of our country, and that for 2,000, 3,000. There are different rates. Then we have these beautiful katpatlis right from Rajasthan. Didi, ye choti wali kitne ki hai? Ha? और बड़ी ये 2,500 का. So you can bargain here a lot. She's telling me like twice the amount it is, because I've got it from Rajasthan itself, which you must have seen in my previous vlogs, for a cheaper price. And then you have some home decor items, which looks really pretty. I have come here specifically to taste the food of this place, like, and that's the main motto of me coming here. A lot of beautiful paintings. These are so beautiful. ये दीदी, एक पेंटिंग कितने की होगी? ये पेंटिंग कितने की होगी? 3,500. हाँ. So as you have heard the price, it's 3,500 as he's saying, but you can always bargain. Learn to bargain, guys. If you are in Delhi, you are coming to Delhi, learn to bargain. And then we have, I think, the shop is from Madhya Pradesh, and it's all chicken work. So these are some spices from different places. This is basically from Maharashtra. So I'm giving you the information really slowly and softly because some of the vendors doesn't like cameras, and when you're speaking on it, they don't like it more. So that's why I'm quite slow. Study product. It's very big, guys. More shawls. 100% sheep wool. There are some gajak and some chikki from Rajasthan. You can get some achar also. More of beautiful things, aesthetics. So finally, my heaven is. I have entered my heaven for which I've come here, that is food, and there are a lot of places which is divided on the basis of states, and I specifically want to eat Nagalandian cuisines for which I've come here. So guys, here you can ask this guy to make your sketch, and it's very affordable, it's not expensive at all, and it's making in 10 to 15 minutes, and it's like 500-700, and it's really good. These kind of talents, I don't know from where people get it, it's such a nice talent. And there are some gifts for your loved ones. So right now the place I went was Uttarakhand, which I don't want to eat. Now this is Shillong, and then you also have Arunachal Pradesh, and you'll get the specific cuisine of that place, the things that are famous there. It's a place to come with your friends. So beautiful. Northeast organic. Hi, hi, hi Tugu, hi, hi. So here we are in Sikkim now. You can try cuisines from Sikkim. And I'm all alone today. I wanted to come with my friends, but they were really tired, so they told me no for today. Well, that's fine. Sometimes it's good to explore all alone. So I encountered another state, that is Tamil Nadu, and you're getting all kind of cuisines over here. Chameleon cuisine, what we say, and then we have khadi, and then there are a lot of things to shop. It's just a little overpriced. This place is a little overpriced, so you have to know how to bargain. And so here is Nagaland. I was hunting for this, and finally I'm here. Nagaland. I have been to a couple of northeastern states, but I did not get specific food there also. So that's why I want to eat this. So I'll just try something and tell you. We have Maharashtra also anyways, but I'm here for this. So I'll try some cuisines and tell you how it is. There's a bad news that this place is good for non-vegetarians. You guys have a lot of options, but for vegetarian you don't have much options. And Nagaland specifically, I just forgot that Nagaland specifically eats more of non-veg food. So I asked him, what's the most spiciest vegetarian dish that you have? And he was like, we have chili burrito, we have chili paneer. But that's not something Nagalandian. But there's another shop, and that's also a Nagaland food stall. I'm gonna go and check and try something over there. Something over there. Maybe it's paneer or whatever it is. I'm just gonna try it because I'll just tell them to make it really spicy. Nagaland spicy, because Nagaland is famous for spicy. Nagaland is famous for spiciness in their food. So I'm going and I'm telling you what I'm gonna eat. So guys, I've just ordered a Nagalandian vegetable thali with some boiled veggies and some three chutneys that they'll be serving in that thali. And I'm just gonna try, and because it was vegetarian and it was something from Nagaland, that's why I have taken it, and I'm gonna taste and tell you how it does taste. Just to give you a little bit of knowledge that this place is for non-vegetarians. If you love non-veg, if you love pork, if you love chicken, mutton, then guys, this place is just for you. For vegetarian, you have a very less amount of varieties that they offer, but at the end of the day, you get something if you're coming along with your friends, or you can try some other state like Meghalaya, Assam, or most of them don't have a vegetarian dish. But then also, if you find, like, if you are really excited, really, really want to eat something, like I wanted to eat something, I wanted to eat something Nagalandian, specifically Nagalandian, I have researched 2-3 places, 4 places, and then I found the perfect thing for myself. So if you are really into eating, then you'll get end up eating something vegetarian, if you are vegetarian. Otherwise, for non-vegetarian, this place is yours. This place is full of non-vegetarians, non-vegetable dishes. That's all I wanted to tell you. So just wait for some times. I'm gonna show you what I have ordered, and I'm gonna tell you how it does taste. I think it will gonna taste well and spicy. So guys, my food is here, and it took around 5 to 10 minutes for them to make it, and that was really quick because nobody anywhere gives it so spontaneously, as I say. And now I'm gonna tell you what all things I have in my thali. Okay, so guys, this is the thali that I've ordered. So I'm gonna tell you what I have, which I have asked from the person who served me this. So this is aloo ki chutney for them, this is chane ki chutney for them, and this is tomato ki chutney for them. And then there is some Nagalandian styled cooked bangan, I guess it is, but it's really different. I don't think so, it's bangan, it's some sort of beans, I guess. Then they have this dal, and then boiled, oh nice. So we have mushroom and some broccolis, and then we have some boiled vegetables, rice and lemon. So this is what I'm gonna try, and I'm gonna tell you how it does taste. So keep watching. So guys, this is sticky rice. This is sticky rice, and this dal is, I still don't know what kind of dal it is, but this thing is very spicy, which is really good. It's really tasty. I'll try some boiled vegetables also. Just wait and until I tell you how it does taste. So guys, I have finished eating my stuff, and the stuff was really spicy, but it wasn't that good. Frankly speaking, it wasn't good at all. Not at all, but it was not for someone like me. It was like more of masalas and stuff. it may, you may love this, but for me it wasn't that good. Like, I'll give 2.8 out of 5, but that is what it is. And right now I'm at a place where some regional dances are going on, and right now some Punjabi song is going on and people are dancing. Specific Punjabi people, maybe. So right now I'm just in some kind of alley. Lot of shops and shops. So guys, there are a lot of indie items, and this is some kind of there are a lot of antique things over here, herbal and antique things, but these are ridiculously expensive. Like this box of this is some kind of magnifying glass. This is for 4,000 rupees and it's really expensive. Oh, it's really expensive. So I told you that I'm gonna tell you a funny thing. So here's the story. So there was a tarot card reader or some kind of Jyotishi was right there, and he was telling the most funniest thing in this world that you're gonna hear. She said you only have to do some mantras that she asked her to read and stuff, and she said how can I lose fat. She told her some kind of things, like they were giving some kind of sachet or whatever, I don't know, and she said ki I do gym also. The what we say, this was the one I'm talking about, and she said that I do a little bit of gym also, so if I'll continue your prescribed some kind of sachet was there, I don't know what was that, and gym, then it will be helpful more. But the tarot card said no, you don't have to do gym. The day you'll do gym, you'll feel very bad. What's the, like, she said that gym is not for you, it's not meant for you, and if you'll do gym, you'll not be happy. And I don't know why she said that, and she's the most stupidest whatever. How can someone say that if you're gonna do gym, it's not good for you, you'll become unhappy, and I don't know where these people come from and why they come, but this is what it is. It's a business. People will wanna tell shitty things to you, but you don't have to believe on them. You just have to trust your guts, nothing else. So guys, I think I'm done with Delhi Heart. I have covered most of the things in this place, and it's 5:30 in the evening and started to become a little dark, and I want to reach my home quite a bit, like by 8, so if I leave it right now, I'll reach there by 7:30 or 7, so, and maybe traffics and stuff, so I'm ending my vlog right over here, and if you like the video, please hit the like button, and if you don't like it, then also please like it and tell me the reason why are you not liking it in the comment section, so I'll get a feedback to improve my videos, because it's a very new channel, it's a very tender channel, so I need feedbacks from you. So you can follow me on my Instagram, which is somewhere right here, or You'll see at the end of the video, you can see the links in my description below. For my previous videos also, you can see the description box, and I'll meet you in the next one.